Many people ask, why do we walk upright whilst most other mammals, especially primates, walk on all their fours? Well, a known fact. Our ancestors have been walking upright for at least 7 million years. Bipedalism separated the first hominins from the rest of the four-legged apes. Yes, they did climb trees, but they walked on the ground as well. This flexibility helps them get around in diverse habitats and cope with changing climates. The oldest evidence for walking on two legs comes from one of the earliest ancestors known as the Sahelanthropus. As this species lived in the diverse habitats, including forests and grasslands, walking upright might have helped the individual survive. Sahelanthropus had a combination of ape-like and human-like features. In fact, from at least 6 to 3 million years ago, early humans combined ape-like and human-like ways to move around. For this reason, we see a gradual transition from climbing trees to walking upright on a regular basis. The earliest indisputable evidence that our distant ancestors had shifted from four legs to two, becoming bipeds, were the footprints unearthed at Laetoli, close to Tanzania's Olduvai Gorge, an area rich in fossils of our prehistoric ancestors. Now, every time we take a step, we briefly stand on one leg, putting stress on our leg bones. This causes a white area of bone just below the knee joint to develop as a result of that stress, and it is what we see in Australopithecus animensis, which existed about 4 million years ago, providing a strong evidence that this individual walked upright. Fossils from around this time period were the ones that lived near open areas and dense woods. Their bodies had evolved in ways that enabled them to walk upright most of the time but still climb trees, and as a result, they could take advantage of both habitats. By 2.5 million years ago, in Australopithecus africanus, a curve in the spine has been observed. This curve of our lower back helps absorb shock when we walk, thus another evidence of bipedalism. Another evidence was witnessed in Homo erectus about 1.9 million years ago, where the size and broad shape of the hip bones, pelvis, and thigh bones are similar to modern humans. Overall, our ancestors went through several fundamental anatomical modifications to shift from four legs to two. The pelvis changed from being tall and flat from front to back to being much shorter and more bowl-shaped, giving better leverage for the muscles that move the hip in upright walking, and the angle of the thigh bone changed to point inwards, bringing our feet more directly under the center of our bodies. Well, we have seen the changes that occurred bringing our ancestors to shift from all fours to two legs. Let us get to the why. As Africa changed, losing some of its forests as vast grasslands grew, bipedalism made more sense in an environment where trees were rare. Being upright allowed them to see over long grass to scan for predators and prey. But then again, there are those that oppose this theory for their own reasons. During the last century, approximately 30 hypotheses have been proposed to explain the evolution of the human upright posture. Some researchers have linked the change to a shift in hunting strategy. Two-legged apes could throw weapons and so take on bigger, faster-moving prey, while others say it helped our ancestors stay cool under the hot African sun. Another theory suggests that it may have been changes in the geological landscape that helped shape our ancestors move onto two legs. With all these theories, one thing for sure though is walking upright freed the hands for carrying and manipulating tools, enabling early humans to appear larger and more intimidating, and helping early humans cover wide open landscapes quickly and efficiently. But the main question is not why they stood upright or walked upright, but why did they remain like that even after? Exactly why and when our ancestors stood upright and started moving around on two feet is still shrouded in mystery. The scientific community may disagree over what led early humans to abandon a life on all fours, but all these hypotheses did contribute in their own way to the understanding of bipedalism. Understanding how we came to be the bipedal creatures we are today promises to answer many of the fundamental questions we have about the evolution of our species. Every new discovery has the potential to fundamentally change how we understand the origins of one of our most distinctive traits. So what do you think of this, guys? Let us know in the comments section down below. For more related videos on human evolution, do check our channel out and do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel.